family tonight, a White House first. Naomi Biden became the first granddaughter of a president to be married at the executive mansion today. The 28-year-old and her fiancé took their vows on the South Lawn, joining a rare tradition. Here again is CBS's Natalie Brand.
It's an exclusive club in history dating back to 1812. Only 19 White House weddings hosted by the president and first lady, 10 of them for presidential children. Trisha Nixon and Edward Cox's ceremony was recorded for the American public to see. The Rose Garden, their backdrop, complete with a 12-foot gazebo.
Planning is extraordinary, as with any White House event.
Stuart McLaurin, the president of the White House Historical Association, says he still has the three-ring binder used to plan the Nixon wedding in 1971.
You see the erased names and moving around if everyone was seated. You see the menu planning and the recipes for the extraordinary cake.
The six-tiered cake towered nearly 7 feet, nicknamed Washington's newest monument. A few years earlier, Linda Bird Johnson's marriage to Marine Captain Charles Robb included a saber arch in the East Room. His sword used to slice through their 250-pound pound cake. Tradition mixed with personal touch.
On occasions like a wedding at the White House, we are reminded that the White House is not just the office to the president and his staff, but it's the home to a family.
But a first family's wedding captures the interest of the public and the press. The 1906 nuptials of President Teddy Roosevelt's daughter, nicknamed Princess Alice, dominated the news cycle.
It's kind of the American version of a royal wedding.
It is. In fact, the first celebrity wedding, if you will, in our country took place with Alice Roosevelt in the beginning of the 20th century.
This was the gown worn by President Monroe's daughter, Mariah Hester, in 1820.
A 1966 CBS special looked at some of the gowns worn by White House brides. Only one president, Grover Cleveland, exchanged his vows at the executive mansion inside the Blue Room in 1886. Naomi Biden is the first presidential granddaughter to say her I do's at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue and the first to use the South Lawn, cementing her place in White House history. Natalie Brandt, CBS News, Washington.